Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today we're going to show a treatment and demonstrate radius along the jawline. The jawline's the theme for 2018. So we're going to do jawline with radius. Important to cleanse the area. A lot of controversy over what we're using now, hypochlorous and peroxide and alcohol. Some people use HibiCleanse. It's important to cleanse the area. That's the key. And cleanse several times to demonstrate what we're doing. The bone loss really occurs at the back of the mandible, at the angle of the jaw. You can see this area has a relative hollow. You want to keep some hollow so that you have a beautiful high cheek with definition below. But you'll see some lines here. We'll fill through here, but right in this zone is really where we want to create volume and fill this area. The idea is it's going to move the tissues back to help with the downturn of the mouth and recreate the volume that was lost at the angle of the mandible. If there is a pre-jowl here, so minimal here, we won't have to address it today, but you can come in here. Be mindful that bite down for me. In front of the masseter is your facial artery coming up here, but we're superficial to that. But you can come in here with the cannula and inject the pre-jowl to straighten that out if we needed to. Today we're addressing the posterior. Here we're creating the opening. And we're using the 22 gauge cannula, so we use a larger needle to create the opening, and then finding where we created it, coming in with the cannula, not injecting here because there'd be too much product superficially, but advancing the cannula. It's important to know a lot of times there's no pain here for the patient, but you're pushing because most of the pain fibers are superficial, and then now we can start injecting product. What that's going to do is create a potential space, so it's easier to therefore advance the cannula. Injecting and pulling back. So not really bolusing, but injecting in a retrograde fashion and following the natural contour of the jaw to create that volume. I'm really aiming for here at that angle, but I'm watching to see, remembering that the tip of the cannula is proximal. The opening of the cannula is proximal to the tip. It's not exactly at the tip. So we have to account for that and overshoot a little bit. And you can see we're creating volume just in front of the ear. And you can really do a lot of things. You could come down and really create more of a jaw. But in this case, we're just recreating what was lost in fat and bone. And then coming down just inferior to the jaw. Always knowing where the mandible is so that we're keeping the line straight. So, and it should be fairly painless. And you can see volume here. And we're going to go and fill the area just in front of the ear. Let's come through that same opening. Right through that same opening. And advancing through product. And because it's 2 inch in length, it gives us some reach, and you can see the cannula is flexible. A lot of people like different cannulas based on the flexibility and the ease of flow through the product. And the 22 gauge, it really flows easily, so you have to be careful not to put too much product in. Here I'm in the preauricular area on top of the parotid, and just creating some volume. Someone gets a facelift, it's in here that we're removing skin, and so that's a good landmark to give an idea of what we're doing. We're really pulling back there by first adding volume. Unless there's a lot of loose skin, we can often do it with fillers and collagen stimulators. Radius will last long here because it's not a movement area. Fillers go quicker where we're moving. And then I'm just recreating that angle. And you can see I'm not bolusing, but I'm really going back and forth, watching the fill as I go to see where I'm putting the product. Again, we're on top of parotid, and the parotid duct goes to the edge of the mouth, the oral commissure here. So we're much posterior to the duct, but using the cannula is safer than a needle. Now, you could mold that if you wanted to and create a defined jaw. And if someone wanted an even stronger jaw, you could go along the whole length here. So that's creating the jawline posteriorly to pull up from the edge of the oral commissure to create a nice, a little more squared look in keeping with a triangular. We don't want to fill it too much to square the patient's aesthetic look. So that's the patient's one side. We will now go and fill the other side to complete the treatment. So thanks for joining me in this video of radius along the jawline. Jawline, as you see, is very important to address. Let us know what you thought of the video in the comments below. Let us know the techniques that you use and the products that you use to create a beautiful jawline. Subscribe to this YouTube channel to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.